Hello again, my name is Tim Spector from the ZOE COVID Symptom Study, and I wanted to give you this week's update, which starts with an optimistic note, basically because of the exciting news about the viral vaccine that Pfizer developed, shows great promise that even if that vaccine doesn't pan out, lots of the other ones should do. So there is end in sight, and most people think that this should start to be rolled out on a large scale by about the spring. The downside is, of course, we've got to survive another difficult winter. The virus is still around us and we certainly haven't beaten it yet. The other bit of good news is that thanks to everyone's efforts, the R value and the number of infections has come down now across the UK and across all four nations to below one. And although there are regional variations, that's fantastic news. The numbers are still high at around 35,000 cases a day, but nevertheless, it's all going in the right direction. The biggest drops were seen in places like Scotland and the northwest of England, where rates are now back to where they were at the beginning of October. We still have a way to go, but encouraging also is that areas that were less affected in the south of the country, southeast, southwest, east of England, who were in tier one, are already seeing drops. And so that's fantastic. And London is looking like it's going to start going down fast soon as well. The only caveat is that there are some areas that are going the wrong way and we don't know why. And one area like that is the Midlands, where rates are still rising, and that is a slight worry. We also need to keep an eye on the elderly population. The over 60 is the ones who ends up in hospital. But so far, most of the regions are seeing those levels coming down as well. Want to also remind you about our schools initiative, which we launched last week. If you're an interested parent or a teacher, do go to our website and sign up along with the hundreds of other schools that have already started the scheme, which is a great way to learn more about the virus in children and also inform you about the various risks associated with your school or not, and is really important bit of research. The other is about the vaccine itself, and nearly a million of you volunteered to be in our vaccine trials, which are still ongoing, but I want to thank all of you, but also the thousands that have already taken part in some of these trials. Some are still reporting, but without you, really, none of us would have a vaccine. So a big thank you there. Finally, you will have noticed in the app that we've added yet more questions on symptoms based on the feedback you gave us. And so we can fully describe what the virus is doing to people. And hopefully this makes it easier for you to log as well. Do send us feedback as you do that. And once you finish logging every day, do remember that there's a button just below that allows you to see the full report. And this is the full report that we send to the government and the NHS every day. So you're as fully informed as anyone in the country when you're using our app. And our aim is to give you transparent, fast information rapidly so people can make their own decisions and we can all act appropriately. So that's it. Stay safe. Keep logging. Thanks for your support.